We want to determine f of x given that f prime of x is equal to 3x squared and f of 2 is equal to 7. So we want to determine a function that has a derivative of 3x squared and f of 2 is equal to 7. Well, determining a function that has a known derivative should remind us of the antiderivative. In general, the antiderivative, or indefinite integral of f prime of x with respect to x, is going to equal f of x plus a constant c. This function here will have a derivative of f prime of x. So from the given information, the indefinite integral of 3x squared with respect to x would be equal to our function plus a constant. And then we can determine the constant because we're given f of 2 is equal to 7. So this antiderivative would be 3 times, this would be x to the third divided by 3 plus c. These 3's simplify out, so we're left with x cubed plus c. So we know that f of x must be equal to x cubed plus c. This is a family of functions that have a derivative of 3x squared. But since we're also given that f of 2 is equal to 7, we can determine the exact value of c to determine what's called the particular solution to this problem. So f of 2 must equal 2 cubed plus c, which must equal 7. So we have 8 plus c equals 7. Subtracting 8 on both sides, we have c equals negative 1, which means the particular solution, or the exact function that satisfies these conditions, would be x cubed minus 1. Let's take a look at this graphically. What we're seeing here is the graph of several functions that have a derivative of 3x squared. So all these functions are a member of the family of f of x equals x cubed plus c. But since we were given that f of 2 equals 7, which means when x is 2, y has to be 7, this point must be on the exact function that we're looking for, which is this point here. And notice that the only function that contains this point is f of x equals x cubed minus 1. Which is the particular solution that satisfies the given conditions. I hope you found this helpful.